Let's go right now to WDSU reporter Travers Mackle live there on the scene. Travers, what do we know so far?
Christina, it was a chaotic, hectic scene on the city's most famous street. This deadly, tragic shooting happened just after 3 a.m. here in the 400 block of Bourbon Street. According to the NOPD, everything went down inside Willie's Chicken Shack. They say that there was an unruly customer inside, so a private security guard was trying to escort that person out of the establishment. According to cops, the unruly customer then went for the guard's gun. The two struggled and shots rang out. According to police, the unruly suspect was shot, the guard was shot, and two other people were shot, a man and a female who police say was just walking by. She was shot once in the head. She died here at the scene.
WDSU exclusive one-on-one with the Democratic presidential frontrunner. He did an exclusive interview with WDSU News immediately following his event at the YEP Center.
Yeah, WDSU's Travers Mackle talked to Biden. Travers, you asked him some questions that many of you may want answered. What did he say?
That's right. We had the chance to ask him about a lot of local issues that people are talking about. He talked criminal justice reform, campaigning in a ruby red state. He actually feels that a Democrat can carry this state in a presidential election, and the crumbling infrastructure in New Orleans. He's aware of the current flooding issues and says it needs to stop. New Orleans right now is dealing with critical infrastructure needs. We've dealt with flooding issues for normal rainstorms. We have a lot of issues here. If elected, how could you help the city of New Orleans with its fragile and in some cases crumbling infrastructure?
We should have a major infrastructure bill. Congressman Cedric Grierson has been talking about it, a lot of people.
Every storm is different. You never know what it's going to do. Like I said, no one thought Katrina was going to be Katrina. And if the levees held up, there would have been no Katrina, because while Katrina was a serious storm, it blew windows out of downtown hotels. There was a lot of wind damage. That was a disaster that was created when the levee system failed. When those three levees, the 17th Street Canal, the London Avenue Canal, and the Industrial Canal, all failed, it flooded New Orleans and it changed how we prepare for storms. You listen to emergency leaders now, there are no shelters of last resort. The Superdome, the Convention Center, the airport, these were all shelters of last resort. And when the levees break and the city floods, nobody can get out and people are trapped. You know, in 08, it was the only time in the history of New Orleans that they ever called for a mandatory evacuation. They didn't call for one in 98 for Georges. They didn't call for one in 04 for Ivan. They didn't call for one in 05 for Katrina. 08, former Mayor Ray Nagin said, this is the mother of all storms. It's going to be the big one. New Orleans evacuated in 72 hours because they didn't want people in the city. You can't do the vertical evacuations anymore. So I think New Orleans and emergency leaders in Southeast Louisiana do things the right way. They have everything on standby with state and federal partners. So the big difference is from even 12 for Isaac to now is that I think people learn from every storm. So really quickly, man, we have a guy who was inside a construction worker. Royce, don't go anywhere. What's your name?
David.
What was it like when this happened?
I can't even explain it, man. It was like,
hearing it, it was
crazy. That sound, like how it then watching the floor hit and watching guys go over the side, like, I don't know, man, it's just crazy.
What floor were you on? Where were you when this happened?
I was on the 14th.
The 14th?
Yes, sir.
On the top?
Yeah, not on the top. The top is 18, so I'm like, I'm inside the building. So I was inside the building on like the 14th floor.
How did you get down?
Oh, what we had to do is jump down and go down the back side. The back side got like scaffolds, so go down the scaffold stairs in the back.
Yeah. Have you ever seen anything like this before? You work in construction. Have you ever seen anything like this?
Not personally. You see stuff like on Instagram, Facebook, and stuff like that. But personally, nah, this is my first time, man. It got me rattled. Got my head shaking up.
It's a story WDSU Investigates broke earlier today.
Investigative reporter Travers Mackle is live at federal court with the latest on this bizarre story. Travers.
That's right, Sean. The criminal complaint was unsealed earlier today here at federal court. In it, the FBI alleges that a man close to Tyrann Mathieu allegedly tried to fleece him for millions of dollars.